Good morning, guys. So, we will start our next lecture. In previous lecture, we have discussed the problems related to your power system. Okay. So, in previous lectures, we have discussed about the construction of the global stiffness matrix for this one-dimensional power element. Then we have solved 2 to 3 examples related to your one-dimensional power system. Okay, in this we have applied our finite elemental procedure. Likewise, actually I will repeat this procedure here, or revise this procedure here. So first step was to find out the elemental stiffness matrices. Second step was, first was to find out the elemental stiffness matrices for each element. The next is what? To construct the global stiffness matrix by using these elemental stiffness matrices. Then next is what? Formulate this force displacement and displacement vector, force displacement relationship. Formulate this force and displacement vector relationship by using this global stiffness matrix. Okay. Then next is what? Then apply the boundary conditions. Means boundary conditions for your force vector. Then next boundary condition for your displacement vector. And then next is what? Apply the elimination approach to get the displacement values. Okay, so in this way, you will get first the displacement values. Then by using these displacement values, you will get the force values. Okay, so in this way, we have determined our the displacement, stresses, strain, reactions values for the one-dimensional power system. Now, in this lecture, we are going to study what will be the effect of temperature. What will be the effect of temperature stresses in this one-dimensional power system? Okay, if the temperature effect is there, then what will be the temperature stresses? Or what, due to this temperature effect, what will be the strain, stresses, reactions, or as well as your displacement values will be there. Okay, so in this lecture, we will study the temperature stresses. As you know that in your strength of material theory, you have gone through this, you studied this concept of this temperature stresses. As we know that if the bar is free to expand, okay, then there will not be any stresses will be occurring in this member. But if the bar is constrained, or if the free expansion of this bar is prevented, then there must be some type of stresses will be occurring in this material due to this temperature effect, as we have studied this concept in your strength of material subject. Okay, so as we know that, let us consider this is an example. Okay, delta T is the temperature difference of this material and surrounding. Alpha is the coefficient of thermal expansion. Okay, if this bar is free to expand, then there will not be any type of stresses will be occurring in this material. But if this bar is prevented, if this bar is constrained or prevented to free expansion by this temperature effect, then there must be some type of stresses will be occurring in this material. Okay, and what will be these stresses, or what will be these temperature stresses, temperature strains that we are going to study? And after same procedure, we are going to apply to find out such type of problems, means the one-dimensional bar with temperature stresses. Okay, so first, as we know that if small l is the length of this bar, l is the length of this bar, and if this material is free to expand, and if this free expansion, now the question is what? what will be this first free expansion? And if we get this free expansion, then we can proceed to find out our strain, then stress, and then finally force. Okay. So as we know that from the strength of material theory, the free expansion, this free expansion is given by formula L times alpha delta. Okay, where L is the length of material, alpha is the coefficient of thermal expansion, and delta T is the temperature difference between material and surrounding. Okay. So if this is the free expansion, then we know that the strain is given by formula. Strain will become equal to change in length due to this free expansion. Actually, this free expansion is nothing but the change in length due to the temperature. So change in length divided by original. This is your strain value. So strain will become equal to alpha delta minus L. It will get cancelled to each other. Okay. So this is the strain value, alpha times delta. This is due to the temperature effect. Okay. Now next is what? If this is strain, then stress is given by formula. Stress is nothing but E times strain. Okay, so stress sigma will become E times alpha delta. Okay, so if this is stress value, then force is given by formula stress into area. As we know that stress is equal to force upon area. Okay, so force is equal to stress times area. So stress is given by the formula stress is nothing but E times alpha delta. Force is nothing but sigma into A. So your force will become E A alpha delta. Okay, so this is the force value which will be acting for this element. Means what? If this is the force value due to this temperature difference. So suppose if this is the element, if we consider one element, first node, second node. If this force is acting on this node 2 in this direction, E, A, alpha, delta, B, then there must be the same amount of force will be acting in the opposite to this direction at node 1 to keep this element in equilibrium due to the temperature effect. Okay, so this is the E, A, alpha, delta, B. So this is negative value. So due to these two forces, this element will be in equilibrium. So F is equal to E A alpha delta T. If it is acting at node in the positive direction, then there must be the same amount of force will be acting in the opposite to this direction at node 1, and which is nothing but minus E A alpha delta T. So in this way, for this element, for this entire element, what will be the force, nodal force vector then? Okay, so the nodal force vector for this element will become nodal force vector for this element will become as there are two nodes, it will be there will be two equations or two values for this force vector. So it will become minus E A alpha delta T plus E A alpha delta. Okay, so this is the force vector for this element due to temperature effect. Okay, so this force value will be acting, or it should be acting at node 1, and this force value is acting at node 2. Okay, so in this way you can write the force vector for this element. Now suppose if there are two elements,
if there are two elements with E1 alpha 1 L1 and if the delta T is common for this material, if there are two elements with values E1 alpha 1 L1 and E2 alpha 2 L2, okay, then what will be the force vector for this system? Two element system. Okay. For one element, here we have written the force vector as minus Ea alpha delta t minus n plus Ea alpha delta. Then what will be the force vector for this two elemental bar system due to the temperature effect delta t? Okay. So we can write this force vector for this two elemental bar system as, this is first element and this is second element. Okay, so this will, for first element we can write it as E1 alpha 1 E1 alpha 1 A1, this is A1 and this is A2, E1 alpha 1 A1 delta t minus and plus E1 alpha 1 A1 delta t. Okay, and this will be, actually it will lie between node 1 and node 2. Okay, this is the nodal force vector for element 1. Now similarly we can write the nodal force vector for element 2 also. So this will become F2, it will become, for second element the properties are E2 alpha 2 L2 A2, so it will become E2 alpha 2 A2 delta T minus, because for this element at left node or for this second node there must be a negative end and at right node there must be a positive end, so it will become minus E2 alpha 2 A2 delta T plus E2 alpha 2 A2 delta. Okay, and then finally we will combine these two effects to get the force vector F1, F2. Actually this force vector, it lies between node 2 and node 2. Okay. This first element is in between node 1 and node 2. Second element is in between node 2 and node 3. So the combined effect to get the force vectors F1, F2, it will be like F1, F2 is equal, as there are three nodes, so first, second and third. Okay, so we can write this as, for first and second node, these are the values, minus E1 alpha 1 A1 delta T, so minus E1 alpha 1 A1 delta T. Then for next is E1 alpha 1 A1 delta T. E1 alpha 1 A1 delta T. This is for first and second. As we have during our construction of global stiffness matrix, we need to only map the values between nodes or between positions. Similarly, here we are mapping our values. So between 1 and 2, we have written this. Or between 2 and 3, we need to write this. So for this two second node, there must be a value of minus E2 alpha 2 A2 delta T. And for third node, this is plus E2 alpha 2 A2 delta T. E2 alpha 2 A2 delta T. So this will be our final force vector for this two elemental bar system. Okay. In this way you can proceed to find out the force vector due to the temperature effect. Okay, so in this way you will get the force vector F1, F2. If we add another element, suppose if we add another element, then there must be a four
loaded system. Okay, for this case, then here between third and fourth, sub E3 alpha 3 E3 delta T, and finally for fourth row E3 alpha 3 E3 delta T. Okay, this will be the final force vector for this three bar system. Okay, in this way you need to construct, or you have to construct the force vectors for this three spin system. This will become F1, F2, F3, and these are the final equivalent force system. Okay, now in this way you can proceed to find out the force vector for the bar system due to the temperature. Now next is what? To find out the strain and stress due to this temperature. As we know that free expansion is equal to L times alpha delta, this is the free expansion. Now we know that the total displacement will be equal to the displacement due to elastic strength plus displacement due to temperature effect, or due to temperature rise. You can say this temperature rise. Okay. Now we need to find out this displacement due to the elastic strain. As we know that the total displacement for this element, or this element, is given by this formula. As we have proceeded, already we have discussed this. U2 minus U1 is the total displacement for this element, is equal to, let us say, the displacement due to the elastic strain is equal to U, plus displacement due to the temperature effect is equal to L times alpha delta, plus L times alpha delta. Then the displacement due to elastic strain is given by, okay, it will become equal to U is equal to U2 minus U1 minus L times alpha delta. Now this is the displacement. Now elastic strain is given by formula, change in length divided by total length. So U2 minus U1 divided by L, minus similarly L alpha delta T divided by N. So this will become equal to, strain will become equal to U2 minus U1 divided by L, minus L will get cancelled, alpha delta. So finally strain will become equal to 1 upon L in bracket U2 minus U1 minus alpha delta. So finally in simplified form you can write the strain as 1 upon L, or in matrix form you can write it as 1 upon L minus 1 plus 1. This is the matrix, one dimensional, or only one row is there and two columns are there. One row, two column, into U1, U2. Okay. If you read, means minus 1 times U1, here is the minus 1 times U1, minus U1, plus 1 times U1, plus it means U2 minus U1. So this is simplified in the matrix form as 1 upon L minus 1 into 1. Single row, two columns are there, and minus alpha delta. Okay. So in this way you will get the strain vector. Now next is what? Next is to find out the stress. So stress is given by, stress, as we know that the stress is equal to E times strain. Okay, so in this way you will get here E by L into minus 1 plus 1 into U1 into minus E times alpha delta, because we need to multiply this E to this value. So E times epsilon is equal to E by L minus 1 into 1 into 1 minus U1 into minus E times alpha delta. This is the stress value which is occurring for this element 1. Suppose second next here is the element with L2 and U. Then what will be the stress value for this element? So how to write the stress value for this element? Then it will become this sigma 1, sigma 2 will become E by L in bracket minus 1, 1 into, now the changes should be U2 and U3, because for first element U1 and U2, for second element U2, this should be there. So U2, U3 minus E times alpha. Where alpha is related to your second element, E is also related to your second element. So in this way you can proceed to find out the stress values in each element. So basically we have studied that first, if the temperature effect is concerned, is mentioned in the example, also if the coefficient of thermal expansion is given in the example, then there must be the temperature stresses for this material. So if the coefficient of thermal expansion alpha as well as the temperature difference is given in the example, then we need to consider the stresses or force values due to this temperature effect. So for this, if alpha and delta T is given in the example, then what will be the new changes to previous system? So first we need to find out the nodal forces for each element. Okay, so nodal forces for each element. For example, this is the basic formula. Find out the nodal forces, which is given by minus Ea alpha delta T, Ea alpha delta T. Okay, means we need to consider this effect during our calculations. Okay, we need to consider this effect for each element. If there are 2 to 3 elements, then there must be 2 to 3 vectors. And then by adding, you will get the global force vector. Okay, as we know that we have constructed our global stiffness matrix in previous examples, here we need to construct a global force vector. Okay, these are the local force vectors. This is for element 1, suppose. Similarly, we can write this for element 2 also. Minus E2, A2, alpha 2 delta T, plus A2, A2, alpha 2 delta T. So here, you will get the local force vector for the element 1. Similarly, local force vector for the element 2. Now we need to construct the global force vector by using this local force vector, if the temperature effect is mentioned in your exam. Okay, so finally you need to construct the global force vector, then finally you will get the global force vector F1 F2. What will be the global force vector? Simply you need to write this values for this nodes 1 2 3. Means for node 1 there is only one value, for node 2 there are two values, this is first one and this is second one, and for node 3 there is third value, A2 alpha 2 delta. So in this way you need to construct first global force vector. Next is what? Remaining procedure is same. Means first step was find out the elemental stiffness matrices for each element. This is the same, because as the values are same for this elemental stiffness matrices, so elemental stiffness matrix for each element will be same. Second step is what? To construct the the global stiffness matrix from the elemental stiffness matrix. Now third step is what? Before proceeding to your force and displacement relationship, we need to find out the global force vector. Why? Because there are some type of forces acting due to the temperature increase. So we need to find out this force vector due to this temperature effect first. So first find out the elemental force vectors for each element. Okay. First find out the elemental force vector for each element. Then construct it globally to get the global force vector. Okay. This is your global force vector. And by constructing the global force vector, now you can proceed to write down this force and displacement relationship. Okay. Then next step is same. Similarly, we have apply the boundary conditions. Okay, here is the global force vector. Now by applying the boundary conditions, the effect of this fixed supports as well as if a nodal as well as a point force is given, we need to add this point force to this global force vector also. Okay, and we will see such type of rectifications during our examples. Okay, so first is what? Find out elemental stiffness matrix. Then next is what? Construct global stiffness matrix. Then from this find out the local force vector that would have due to this temperature effect. Then find out the global or construct the global force vector by using these local force vectors. Okay, when you will get the global force vector, then write down the force and displacement relationship. Then apply the boundary conditions for the forces as well as for the displacement. Then apply the elimination approach. By applying the elimination approach, you will get only remaining 2 to 3 equations. By solving these 2 to 3 equations, you will get the displacement values. Okay. By getting these displacement values, then next step is what? Find out the reactions. Reactions. Okay. Then next step is what? To find out the stresses. Now stress value here in this example for this system of the stress is given by formula, same formula as we have considered in our previous examples, like E by L in bracket U2 minus U1, but here one term is added, which is what? Minus E times alpha delta. This is the actually this term, it is added due to the temperature. So stress will become, this is your previous value. Now next is what? Updated value is what? Minus this value, minus E times alpha delta. This is due to the temperature effect. Okay, so this is the case, or you need to find out the stress values in this way. Okay, so in this way you can proceed to find out the temperatures. Actually this stress is nothing but your temperature stresses in each element, as well as displacements at each node, as well as the reactions. Okay, so in this way you can proceed for the problem. So only change is what? Force vector is additional change. Next is what? During the stress calculations, one term is added, or one term is we need to subtract it from the original value. Okay, so you need to keep this in mind while solving such type of problems for temperature. Okay, now in next lecture we will see the examples related to your temperature stresses. Okay, here it is only the concept of the temperature stresses. Actually you know the temperature stress concept from your strength of material theory, so you will get such type of concept. But how to apply the finite elemental procedure to temperature stresses, this is what we have studied. Okay, so here I will conclude this lecture, and in next lecture we will see the examples related to your temperature stresses. Okay, thank you.